All right, now I just email this to Dr. Wu. Done. I hope I don't have any genetic disorders. Hey gang, Trace here for DNews with the latest research on human photography. Looking for scientific data in photos has exploded. Analyzing medical images is big business already. Back in 2012, researchers at MIT's Computer Science and Artificial Intelligence Lab were able to use images of the brain and then computer analysis to track how disorders like schizophrenia originate and spread through our gray matter. The network of cells and connections inside of the brain is slowly being decoded and analyzed thanks to photography. But to get this procedure, you have to go get your brain scanned a few times. Not something you can do with a telephone that's in your pocket. Humans take a lot of pictures, especially with the introduction of digital photography. According to 1,000 Memories, humankind has taken 3.5 trillion photos since 1826. But most of those have been digital. We take more photos every minute today than were taken in the entirety of the 19th century, and 3 to 5% of all of those photos are selfies. A neurologist from University College London believes that we love taking selfies because we cannot see our own face, we can only feel it. We're learning to move the face the way we want and show the best version of ourselves. Scientists at Oxford created a computer which can explore the millions of images we create and look for people with Down syndrome, Fragile X syndrome, and progeria. These rare genetic disorders might be overlooked by a human doctor, but not Doogie. It doesn't actually have a name, but I think it should be called Doogie. This guy uses facial recognition software to identify 36 feature points of interest across the face. They call them facial gestalt. The team identified the parts of the face and then diagnosed a disorder based on the photographs. It got it right 93% of the time. As of this month, Doogie knows 90 different diseases, and the more faces it learns, the better it gets at diagnosing. There are 7,000 different inherited disorders, and most go undiagnosed. But if this system could send an email to your doctor, narrowing down the expensive and time-consuming trial and error process of diagnosing some of these rare disorders just by looking to your Facebook or something, that'd be incredible. Hooking something like this into a system with a lot of photos could be a game changer for people with these hidden disorders. The Library of Congress, which is the largest library on the planet, has about 13.7 million photos in its collection. That's pretty good. Facebook has 10,000 times more. Their library is 140 billion photos and is growing fast. As the internet spreads to more and more people and selfies just run amok, the data humanity is creating could potentially give a snapshot of what is happening economically, socially, politically, healthily, and maybe other illies too. There are potential mines of scientific data here. The selfie's future so bright, I gotta wear shades. Worried about privacy? Excited for the data? I'm totally okay with it, but I stand here every day, so my experience is a little different. Why don't you tell us below, and thanks a lot for watching DNews. Subscribe for more every day of the week, and as long as you're in a subscribing mood, come check out our new sister show, Test Tube. We cover world events, trends, and actual, like, real news mixed with a bit of humor. Started looking at real tangible business reasons for why these companies would want to censor pornography, and an easy answer came to mind pretty much immediately: business partners. Hit the subscribe button now and get that show in your inbox the same way you're getting DNews every day.